Denodo Data Bites. Hello everyone, this is Neha, your podcast host, welcoming you to our latest episode of Denodo Data Bites. In today's conversation, we will be focusing on exploring the power of Denodo's new embedded MPP engine, that is the massive parallel processing engine that we have. Leading this conversation would be our guest on the show, Alberto Pan, who is the Executive Vice President and Chief Technical Officer here at Denodo. Before we deep dive into the topic, let me tell you a little bit about Alberto and his journey in the tech industry. Alberto has led product development tasks for all versions of Denodo platform. Additionally, he is also an academic at heart and has authored more than 25 scientific papers in the areas ranging from data virtualization, data integration to web automation. Alberto, wonderful to have you on the show. So can you tell us a little bit about your role and how it has evolved over the years with Denodo for our new listeners, please?
Hi, Neha. Thanks for having me. Well, I have been with Denodo since the very beginning of the company, almost 20 years ago. And my responsibilities have always included overseeing product research and development, product management, and also the roadmap of the Denodo platform. So my role has not changed that much. What has changed a lot, of course, is the company, because when we started Denodo, the company was very small, all the team was in the same location, and now, well, we are a much bigger company. The team is distributed across the globe. So that, of course, changes the work that I do day to day and makes it more complex and also more exciting. But overall, I am still focused on trying to improve the Denodo platform every day and with every release.
Wonderful. Thank you so much, Alberto. That sounds really exciting. So let's start our conversation for the day then. To begin with, my first question for you is, can you talk to us about the rise and fall of data lakes and how this has led to a new generation of cloud data lakes?
Yes, absolutely. Well, the rise of data lakes was initially driven by the need for organizations to store very large amounts of very diverse data without the need for upfront structuring and preparing it. So they could provide more flexibility for downstream analytics and also support more complex data science needs. But however, over time, organizations faced many challenges with data lakes, like lack of governance and data quality controls, lack of data consistency, data discoverability, and also performance issues, especially when running complex analytical queries in real time. And as a consequence of this, many data lake projects never really took off and did not live up to their promise. But in the last few years, we are seeing a new generation of data lakes, which on one hand leverage the scalability and elasticity provided by the cloud, and which also try to address some of the limitations of the first generation of data lakes, like data discovery, agile creation of data products, integration with other data sources, and also ensuring consistent security and governance. And we have many customers using Denodo to help them create and manage these new generation data lakes that we sometimes call logical data lakes. And to ensure the best performance in these scenarios, we have now embedded in our platform our own massive parallel processing engine based on Presto. So our customers don't need any third-party system to accelerate their real-time analytic queries on the data lake.
So moving forward, what is a massive parallel processing engine, or in short, an MPP engine, and what role does it play in effective data storage and management? And also, how does this relate with the cloud data lakes that we just discussed?
Well, an MPP engine is a technology designed to process large volumes of data by distributing the workload across a cluster of processing nodes which run in parallel, right? So that's the reason of the name. And this allows very fast query processing, even with very large data volumes. And therefore, is needed in this new generation of data lakes if you want to enable interactive analytic queries over the large data volumes that you typically have in these data lakes. And in addition, also when combined with modern cloud and containers technology, these systems allow to very easily scale up and down the resources of the cluster. So we can guarantee good performance, but without wasting resources, because the capability of the clusters, the resources that the cluster uses, change dynamically with the workload of the system. And for instance, the Denodo embedded MPP engine runs on Kubernetes. So it can be deployed on premises. It can be also deployed on all major cloud providers. And it supports this type of automatic auto-scaling out of the box. So as I mentioned, the number of processing nodes of the cluster changes dynamically with the workload to ensure that we don't increase costs unnecessarily.
Right, that makes sense. So deep diving a little bit on the utility aspect of it, how has embedding an MPP engine with the Denodo platform benefited our users? Can you tell us a little bit about it?
Yes, of course. Well, first of all, as I mentioned before, it allows a scalable, very fast processing of real-time analytic queries over the data volumes in the data lake without needing any third-party system, right? Because previously, customers using Denodo to help manage their data lakes typically used an external MPP engine for this, and now this is no longer needed. This is integrated with Denodo. And also, it's important to highlight that this embedded MPP engine can also be used by the Denodo optimizer to accelerate queries using data also from other sources, not only from the data lake. And this is also very important because in many cases, forcing to always copy and transform all the data in the data lake to create data products can create bottlenecks and be very slow, can make data provisioning to the business very, very slow. While with Denodo, you have full flexibility to use the best data source or data sources for this data product. And I think Denodo already has the best query optimizer in the market for this type of distributed querying scenarios, thanks to our very advanced pushdown functionalities, also thanks to our AI-based smart caching and acceleration techniques. And now this new embedded MPP engine will accelerate performance even further also in those scenarios.
Great. Thank you for sharing that, Alberto. So what are some other ways where Denodo helps with managing new generation data lakes?
Well, first of all, the logical architecture enabled by Denodo extends the reach of your data lake. Because unless you have all your data stored in a central data lake, which is something that is very, very hard for big organizations, then the data in the lake will need to be integrated with other data sources, with other enterprise data repositories and applications that might be on-premises, might be in other cloud providers, and so on. For instance, let me put you an example. Maybe your customer's behavioral data is in the data lake, but probably customer interactions and customer transaction data maybe are stored in other systems like CRMs, data marts, or even software as a service applications. And copying absolutely all the data in the lake is often impossible or it takes very long in big organizations. And with Denodo, you can integrate and connect all that data together very, very fast. A second aspect where Denodo helps is data discovery. Because Denodo includes its own data catalog, which provides a data marketplace to the users of the data lake. That is a single entry point where the business users, the data scientists, and all the users of the lake can go to search and discover data by browsing data products, using things like tags and categories, using also Google-like search on the metadata and also on the content of the data products. They can also use the catalog's built-in artificial intelligence capabilities to get automatic recommendations of data products that are based on the user's past activity. So in general, data discovery in the data lake becomes much easier and faster. And the third aspect that I want to mention is data governance and security, because Denodo supports very comprehensive data governance and security features, which are crucial for managing data lakes effectively. It offers, for instance, fine-grained access controls, also advanced data masking, using advanced features like, for instance, tag-based semantic policies, which make it much easier to manage large numbers of privacy and security policies. Also supports encryption out of the box. Also offers auditing capabilities to ensure compliance within the data lake environment. It can also, Denodo can also integrate with your data governance tools, So let's say, for instance, that you are maintaining the privacy classifications of your data in a data governance tools like Colibra or IBM, for instance, Denodo can directly import these security classifications into the engine and then apply them during the data delivery process in the data lake. So you have a single entry point where to apply security policies. So in general, Denodo makes it much easier to manage security and governance in data lake for all data sources and all data consumers.
Perfect. So in a nutshell, Denodo basically helps integrate, manage, and deliver the various data that's available for companies. And like, you know, the specialty lies in, you know, data discovery and data governance and security, as you mentioned. So my last question for the topic is, how can our customers get started with the Denodo embedded MPP engine? Can you share some use cases where some of our users have benefited from it?
Yes, of course. Well, the embedded MPP engine is included with our Enterprise Plus subscription of Denodo. And as I said, it runs on Kubernetes, so it can be used either on-premises or in any cloud provider. And we also provide help charts, which automate all the installations and deployment process, so you can get started pretty fast. And actually, there are several resources in our community website, which is at community.denodo.com, that explain the process in detail. So, you know, this is quite straightforward, especially if your team is already familiarized with Kubernetes. And about use cases, yes, of course. For instance, one example is a big multinational bank. They were already using Denodo to help manage their data lake, and they use Denodo to expose more than 1,000 data products that are being consumed by more than 50,000 users worldwide across all the bank. And the embedded MPP engine has allowed them to, first, to simplify their architecture, right? By removing the external components that they were previously using for massive parallel processing. And it has also allowed them to improve performance more than 40% for the data products that are consuming large data volumes from the data lake. So as you can see, those are very, very positive outcomes.
Thank you so much, Alberto, for taking the time to talk to us about everything related to the power of Denodo's new MPP-based engine. I'm sure our listeners would have enjoyed listening to this discussion today. So before we conclude, we have a quick Q&A round in store for you, just like last time. So are you ready?
Yes.
What is your favorite music festival, if you had to name it?
Well, for instance, one thing that I like to do a lot is going to music festivals. Well, I have to say that in the past, I used to go to music festivals more than today because I guess I am becoming old. But it's still something that I do very frequently. For instance, there is a very good one here in Galicia, in Spain, called Atlantic Fest, which takes place in the island of Arosa every July. A very, very nice place with a great beach, a beautiful natural park. It's also a festival that is very family friendly, so you can go with kids. And the music is typically also very good. So it's a very good option for everyone that comes to Spain and Galicia in the summer.
That's wonderful. That sounds very exciting. And my last question for the day is, what is a hobby that you enjoy doing during your weekends or your free time?
Well, I play tennis a lot. I am not very good at it, but I like it. And I also like reading a lot. And I read all types of things, fiction, non-fiction. For instance, talking about music and festivals, I have recently enjoyed reading a book called Supersonic, which tells the rise to fame of the British rock band Oasis. I like Oasis music a lot, and they are also very funny, so I had a great time with the book. And in fiction, I have been reading recently several books by Emily St. John Mandel, like Station 11 and The Glass Hotel. I really think they are excellent, so I would also recommend them to everyone.
Wonderful. Thank you so much for the great recommendations, Alberto. This was a great session indeed, and thank you again for joining us on this episode.
Thank you.
And a quick message to our listeners, if you enjoyed this episode, please head over to www.denodo.com/podcast to find out more resources on all things data.